Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to transform our Linux Mint Cinnamon desktop to look and feel just like macOS. For those of you who might be wondering why you'd want to do this, there are a few reasons. Maybe you've recently switched from a Mac and want a more familiar environment. Or perhaps you simply love the clean, sleek appearance of macOS. The great thing about Linux is that it's all about freedom. You can make your desktop look like anything you want. Windows, macOS, or something completely unique. So, if you're ready to give your Cinnamon desktop that Mac-inspired look, let's get started. First, if you have a large display and find the default icons and text a bit too small, you can easily change the display size to make everything look a little bigger. Just go to System Settings and then open the Display option. From there, go to the Settings tab and enable the Fractional Scaling option. Now you'll have more scaling options available. I recommend setting it to 125%, as that should work perfectly for most users. For me, I'm happy with my current display size, so I won't be changing it. Alright, let's start by downloading our themes. Click the link in the description to get the theme and you'll be redirected to this page. The theme we'll be using is called Space, and it's inspired by the macOS design. Make sure to download both the transparency and light versions of the theme. Once you have both of those, it's time to download an icon theme. Again, you'll find all the links in the description. Just click the link next to the icon heading and you'll be taken to this page. The icons we're using are called header icons, and they're also inspired by the macOS design. Of course, you're free to download other icons like Mac Tahoe or similar ones, they'll give you an exact Mac look. I, however, want a slightly different but still Mac-inspired feel, which is why I'm choosing to download the header icons. Once you're on this page, go ahead and download the header.zip file. Now you should have all three of the files downloaded. Extract each of them one by one. Once they're extracted, you can delete the original .zip or archive files if you want. Now, we're going to set up our windows. Press the Windows plus right arrow to snap this window to the right side of your screen. Next, press Windows plus E to open another file manager window. And then press Windows plus left arrow to snap it to the left side of your screen. In the new window on the left, make sure you're in your home directory. Press Ctrl plus H to show all of your hidden files. Now, right-click on empty space and create a new folder. It's very important that you name it exactly .themes, and don't forget the dot at the beginning. Now, open that folder. Finally, copy or move your Space Light and Space Transparency theme folders into this new .themes folder. Once you've copied the themes, go back to your home directory and create a new folder and name it .icons. You might already have these icons and theme folder present in your home directory. In that case, you don't need to create a new one. Now, open your .icons folder. We're going to put our icons in here, but you can't just copy the main header folder directly, as that won't work. Instead, open the header folder. Inside, you'll see several folders, like header dark, header light, header purple, and so on. Now you can copy all of these folders into your new .icons folder, or you can just select a few specific ones. I'll be selecting these folders and make sure you also copy the main header folder along with the light and dark variants, because we'll be using those later in the setup. Once that's done, you can close your file manager and let's go apply our new theme and icons. Now, go to your applications menu and search for themes, and launch the application. If you're seeing a simplified view, make sure to click on Advanced Settings. First, we will apply the themes to our applications. Click here and you should see your newly installed Space Light and Space Transparency themes there. I will apply the light theme first. As soon as you apply it, you'll see the changes right here in the Themes app. You can also open a few other apps in the background to see how the new theme changes their appearance. Now, I know our theme doesn't look perfect yet, but don't worry. We'll be making it much better later in this video. Now you can try both the light and dark themes and pick the one you like best. After changing the application theme, we'll change the theme for our desktop. Here, I'll be using the Space Transparency theme, and later I'll show you the Space Light theme as well. Once you apply the space transparency theme, you'll notice the difference in your desktop elements. You'll get a new brightness slider that's a little bit thicker, and the background will have a slight transparency. Your volume slider will also get a new look. And if you open your applications menu, you'll see rounded corners and a nice transparency effect. We still haven't applied our new icons, so let's do that now. I've opened both the file manager and system settings so we can see the changes instantly. Click on the icons section. You should now see your new header icons or any others you may have installed. Here are my icons. I'm going to apply the dark version since I'm currently using the dark theme. After you apply the new icon pack, all the icons in your system settings and all your other applications will be changed. And here is what the folder icon looks like. I think it looks great, but let me know what you think in the comments. We also have a header green and a header purple. If you apply one of these, it will just change the color of your folders, while the rest of the icons will stay the same. For now, I'm just going to stick with the default blue. So, now that we've changed the theme and the icons, next we'll be changing our system font. So, I was originally going to install the SF Pro font, which is the font Apple created and uses on macOS devices. But then, by complete accident, I opened their license and agreement. And as it turns out, we can't actually use their font for customizing our desktop. Whoops! The good news is we have a ton of great free and open source fonts that work just as well. For this video, we'll be using the Inter font. You can find the link in the description or just search for it on fonts.google.com. Once you're on the page, click the Get Font button and download the file. After you download the font, go ahead and extract the .zip file. Once it's extracted, you can delete the original .zip file if you want. Now, open the newly extracted folder. Move this window to the side a little bit and open another instance of your file manager. In this new window, press Ctrl plus H if you aren't already seeing your hidden files. And here, create a new folder and name it .fonts, just like we did when we created the .themes and .icons folders earlier. Open that .fonts folder and copy your Inter variable font, the non-italic one, into it. You're free to move the italic font too, if you want, but I'm skipping it since we won't be using it. After that, go to your Applications menu and search for Font Selection, and launch it. Here, we'll apply our new fonts. Click the first option, Default Font, and look for your newly installed Inter font. Select the regular version as this works best for most cases, but feel free to experiment with other variations if you want. Here, I'm also going to change my font size from 10 to 11 pixels. I always increase the font size by 1 pixel, and it makes everything look much sharper. Now, change the font for the desktop and window title options in the same way. After you've applied all the fonts, you won't see the changes everywhere right away, especially not in app title bars. You'll need to reboot your system for the changes to take full effect. So, go ahead and restart your computer, grab some water, and come right back to the video. Now that you've rebooted your system, let's continue. First, right-click on the bottom panel and move it to the top of your screen. Next, we'll install the Plank dock. Open the terminal and simply type Plank and hit Enter. The terminal will likely suggest the command to install it. You can copy and paste this command or type it manually. Press Enter again and the Plank dock will be installed. Once it's installed, search for Plank in the application menu and open it. The dock will activate and appear on your screen. Now that Plank is active, we'll modify a few of its settings. In your terminal, type Plank --preferences and hit Enter. This will launch the Plank Preferences window. Now you can explore all of its preference settings. From here, you can change the theme, enable the icon zooming effect, adjust the icon size, and change the position of the dock. The video is already getting a bit long, so I won't go through every single setting. You're smart enough to figure it out. Since we now have the Plank dock, we don't need that system dock. So just right-click on the panel, enable Edit Mode, and remove this grouped window list applet. Next, we'll install Ulauncher. With Ulauncher, you'll be able to quickly find and launch your programs. It's similar to Mac's Spotlight search, but with a few fewer features. To download it, visit ulauncher.io. Scroll down a bit to see the download options. You can either run a command to install it using the terminal or simply download the Debian package. Here, I'll just download the .deb file. Once it's downloaded, you can install it just like any other software. I already have it installed, but still, I'm going to reinstall it. After it's installed, press Ctrl plus space, and it will appear on your screen. From here, you can search for your applications and files. Ulauncher also supports fuzzy search, which means that even if you make a spelling mistake, it will still show you search results related to your query. To access its preferences, just click this little icon here. From this menu, you can change settings like the keyboard shortcut and themes. You can also browse and install some useful extensions that can make Ulauncher even more powerful. So now you have a super fast launcher to quickly find and open your apps and programs. Now we have a little problem. If you reboot or log out, both Ulauncher and the Plank dock will be gone, and you'll have to relaunch them manually. To fix this, we need to add them to your startup applications. To do that, go to your Applications menu and search for Startup Applications. Once it's open, click the plus icon and choose Application. Here, find Plank and Ulauncher in the list, and click Add for each one. Now, you won't need to manually run them anymore. They will both start automatically every time you log in. Now it's time to customize our top panel. Right-click on the panel and open Panel Settings. Here, you can reduce the panel height to what works best for you. Next, click on the right zone options. You might already have noticed that our battery, sound, and Wi-Fi icons don't look quite right after we changed our icons. So go ahead and increase the size of the symbolic icons. Keep increasing the size until they look sharp. For me, 25 pixels looks perfect. Now you can close the panel settings. I personally find these icons a bit annoying and I'm going to remove them. Just right-click on the panel, enable edit mode, and then remove them. After editing or removing anything, don't forget to disable edit mode. Now everything looks clean and polished. I also have one extra widget here that I'm going to move over to the left. Now this default mint menu icon isn't really matching our new look, so let's change it. Just right-click on the icon and choose Configure. From there, you'll see an option to change your icon. I'm going to select this simple dotted menu icon. But if you have a custom icon you want to use, like a PNG or an SVG file, you can totally do that here. Just click Browse and select your icon. Now our top panel is looking nice, but we still have a problem. This left side of the Applications menu doesn't really look great, and we're going to get rid of it. This section does contain some useful buttons like Power Off and Logout, which you might use. But since I already have a widget called the User Applet on my panel, I can still access those options. If you don't have it, you can add it to your panel now. The User Applet gives you all those same options, like locking your screen, power off, and logout. So let's go ahead and remove that left side panel from the menu. Right-click on the menu icon and choose Configure. Go to the Menu tab and then simply disable this toggle. Now your Applications menu will look much cleaner and nicer. You aren't missing anything, and you still have the User Applet to access those options. Right now, our panel only shows the time, but let's change that to give it more of a macOS feel. Right-click on the Clock Applet and select Configure. Here, enable the Use Custom Date Format option. And if you want more information about the date formats, click this Show Information button. It will show you all the available options for date formats. Or you can simply type this custom code into the date format field to get a macOS style date. You can also scan QR code to get the exact code if you don't want to type it manually. Now we have our Mac-inspired date, which is great. But as you can see, everything looks a little squeezed together and there aren't any gaps in between. To fix this, just go back to the date format field and simply add a space between each of the format codes. That will instantly give everything a bit of room to breathe and make it look much cleaner. Now we will add an option to quickly switch between our dark and light themes. First, right-click on the panel and choose Applets. Click on the Download tab and search for Dark Mode. You should see a Dark Mode applet, this yellow one. Go ahead and download it. Once it's downloaded, go back to the Manage tab. Select the new applet and click the plus button to add it to your panel. Now click the gear icon to access its settings. Here, you'll see a light and dark mode option. Click on Light Mode first. This is where you can tell the applet which themes to use for each setting. Apply the light version of our theme to each of the options here. I've applied our Space Light theme to all of these options. Next, we have Icon Theme option. You should also see your newly installed header icons here. Unfortunately, they aren't showing up for me right now, but if your new icons are showing, go ahead and select the light version of your icon theme. Now, go to the Dark Mode tab and apply the dark theme for each option. Our theme is Space Transparency, so apply it and we're all set. You can now close these windows. And let's see whether our new Dark Mode widget is working. I've opened these two apps so you can see the changes instantly. Now, let's enable dark mode. Boom! Just like that, in a single click, we've changed everything to dark mode. This is a really great feature for anyone who likes to switch between dark and light themes depending on the lighting in their room. I mostly use dark mode, but when I'm in a very brightly lit environment, I prefer the light theme. This light theme has a nice grayish feel, so it won't hurt your eyes like some other, harsher light themes. Next, we'll set up our wallpapers so they also change with our dark and light themes. Here, I have a few wallpapers. Some are for dark mode and some are for light mode. First, create a new folder and name it something like Dark Wallpapers. Place all your dark mode wallpapers inside this folder. Do the same for your light wallpapers. Create another folder named Light Wallpapers and put all your light wallpapers in there. Now, open your applet's window again and access the preferences for the dark mode applet. Go to the Light Mode section and enable the Change Desktop Background option. From here, browse and select your Light Wallpapers folder. Now, do the same for the Dark Mode option. Simply select your Dark Wallpapers folder. And with that, you're done. From now on, whenever you enable or disable Dark Mode, your wallpaper will automatically change to match your theme. Now, some of you might want a transparent background for your top panel instead of a solid one. To do that, simply open your Extensions app, search for the Transparent Panel extension and download it. Once it's downloaded, enable the extension. After you enable it, you'll get a transparent background with a slight black shadow at the top. You can also make the panel completely transparent by adjusting the extension's preferences in its settings. By default, your window control buttons are on the right side. If you'd like to change that to the left to get a more macOS-like feel, it's really easy to do. Just go to System Settings, open the Windows option, and from there, you can change the button layout to the left. Now, let's clean up the appearance of our applications. First, open your File Manager. Go to the top, click on View, and uncheck the Status Bar option. You'll notice that your File Manager looks much cleaner now. The status bar is gone, but you can still use the shortcut keys to zoom in and out. And if you select any file or folder, the information will still appear at the bottom. Now, click the View button again, and this time, uncheck the menu bar. The overall application will look much cleaner, and you can still access the menu anytime by simply pressing the Alt key on your keyboard. You can apply these same steps to clean up the user interface of other apps, like your text editor, to give them a more minimal and polished feel as well. If you open Firefox, you'll notice it doesn't quite match our new theme. So, let's fix that. In the empty space of the top bar, right-click and select Customize Toolbar. At the bottom of the window, uncheck the title bar option. This will remove the default title bar, giving Firefox a much cleaner look with its own buttons next to the tabs. Next, we are going to install the White Sur theme, which will give Firefox a more Safari-like vibe. Just like all the other steps in this video, this is completely optional, so you can skip it if you prefer. From the GitHub page, you'll find all the information related to this theme. First, go ahead and download it. You can either run Git clone if you're comfortable with Git, or you can simply download the zip file. Now, go and extract the zip, and open the extracted folder. You should have these files inside the folder. Right-click in that same directory and open a terminal. And here, run the command .install.sh and hit enter. Your Firefox theme is now installed. You'll notice that Firefox has a brand new look. You can explore the new interface and see how it automatically adapts when you switch between your light and dark themes, giving you a seamless experience. That's pretty much it for this video. I hope this tutorial helped you give your Cinnamon desktop that fresh new look. Thank you for watching.